Yo, what's good? This is St. Joe, boomandbap.com. Today I'm checking out BFD3. If you've been following me for a while, you know I'm a huge fan of BFD. I got BFD Echo, BFD2, really, really dope drum plugin, probably my favorite. I go to this a lot, so I definitely want to kind of show you some of the updates that they did in BFD3. It's been out for a while, something I've been messing with, but again, definitely wanted to show it to you. So we're gonna go in, kind of go through the interface, then of course show you what it sounds like so you can understand why I love this thing so much. It's crazy. Let's get into it.
All right, so here's the BFD3 interface, and if you're familiar with BFD2, the older BFDs, or even BFD Echo, you'll know that the interface changed a lot. But again, definitely my favorite drum plugin when it comes to acoustic drums. I go to this plugin a lot just because I like acoustic sounding drums. So one of the main things for me that they changed in this one is the browser. It's really, really easy to go through, navigate the browser, and even preview things. But you can see you can go for presets, kits, drums, grooves, and you can see your automation. But what I really like is I can go in by library. So if I want to just go to the BFD2 library, I can. The BFD3, if I want to go into the different expansions, I can do that. Or if I want to go through everything, I can do that and quickly just, you know, type in a search or whatever. So really cool there. Of course, you got your mixer down here. Right here is your drum section or your drum kit area. You can click on the different ones. If I were to have something loaded, it would actually trigger them, and then I can mess with all the different settings for that. You got your effects right here. You can see you got your strip. You can drag it up there because you got 6 different slots you can load stuff in per channel. You got your groove editor. The groove editor is really cool because, of course, you know, you can go in and edit your grooves, but you can actually record in real time, so you can make your own drum loops, and you can drag and drop audio and MIDI either as a single file or separately. So cool stuff. And then your key mapping is over there. So let's get into, I'm gonna just start loading up a few sounds, and I want to go specifically to the BFD3. So we'll do kits first. Kits are just gonna be the kit. Now if I want to load a preset, it's gonna load the kit, it's gonna load actual, you know, effects, grooves, all that stuff. So we're just gonna focus on the kits right now, and we'll load up a few just so you can hear what it sounds like. If you just hear how real these drums sound, listen to the velocity depending on how I hit it. And they're all going to be pretty much laid out the same. Of course, each kit is going to be different in terms of what you have. Let's say I want to go here, and I can click on that. You can see right there. You can click on the different ones, and you can look at the different technology for each one. So let's say we got the kick, and now you got your tuning and all that different stuff there. But also down here in the mixer, if you don't want to see all that, just quickly, let's say you want to look at the effects, you can turn them on, choose them from there. Same with the sends and the different tweaks for the drums. So really cool stuff. Like I said, each kit is going to have, you know, some may have the ambient mix, let's say you want to turn that down. Some will have actual compressor channels that they will run through. So really, really dope. But again, I just love the sound of these kits. And a lot of times what I'll do is go in and just build up my own kit from scratch. I'll show you how to do that. You just see, it just sounds good. But you can see, let's say you got all these different channels and you kind of want to see everything at once, you can actually increase the view. So like I said, the interface, a lot of the changes that they made to the interface is really, really cool. Of course, you know, you got different percussion and everything, but again, just listen to the velocity. Really, really dope. So let's go through a few more of these, and then I'll load up a blank kit and show you how you can just build it really quick. crazy stuff. You got some heavy metal kits. Of course, each one's gonna have its own different sound. But you know me, you can use these kits for whatever. Idea with that. This one's really cool. Let's do the one with the stick, the MapleWorks custom. I know, you know, a lot of drummers are gonna, you know, recognize names, and you want to go in and do your different tunings and setups and all that different stuff. As somebody that's not a drummer that just likes drums, man, it's a really, really just flexible for me, because I don't get confused. I can just load up the different sounds and go to town. But if you want to go in and really, really get in detail, you can, and you'll feel right at home. You can see there. Let's do one more. Let's do this smooth jazz, and then I'll do a blank kit. So let's say you got that. Now let's say we want to do a blank kit. I'll go up here. I'll just reset everything, and now we got that. And what I want to do is go for the drums. And I want to be in the BFD3 library, so we'll go for the kicks. And you'll notice I can play these in real time to preview them, but they're not loaded yet. Like I said, there's a lot of little stuff like this that just really enhance the workflow for me. And I've been using BFD for a long time. Do this one. So we'll just click this check mark. Now it's loaded, and we'll go over here to the snares. I kind of like that one with it, so we'll just load that up. And you can see you can go through and build up as many pieces as you want. If you want to add more channels, you can see you can add channels there. But let's go to the hats. Kind of like that one. And now let's say we want to go through and maybe mess with some effects. Go up here. What do I want to add on the kick? Well, I mean, there's a lot of stuff in there you can add. Let's do envelope shaper. Draw some attack in there. A little bit of a sustain. So you got different effects, different presets. I'm just doing something random. Let's do a bit crusher on there. You hear that bit crush effect? I won't turn it down too much. I'm thinking like 12 bit. So we go over here to our snare. You can see the stuff that's already on there. And maybe we want, you know, you can throw a delay on there, a ring. Let's throw a ring mod, see what that does. So you can see how quick it is to just go through and start building up stuff. And again, let's say, I'll show you the groove editor. I think this would be a good time to do that. So say we want to go over here to the groove editor. We'll say new groove. You can see right there the actual BPM. We'll just turn it down a little bit just because I know I'm normally work at that. So let's do we'll do two bars. make a little two bar, and we'll just hit record, hit this. Then I can go through. I can undo it. See how quick it is to go in and make your own grooves, and I can actually drag this out, do whatever I want to do with it, drag it out as MIDI, I can drag it out as audio. So again, being able to record your own grooves in real time, in addition to, I mean, of course you get a whole bunch of crazy grooves in the library as well, so crazy stuff. Now with that, let's do, I'll load up a preset just to show you the difference. So let's say you want to load up some presets. Again, we'll go to BFD3. And you can see the different types of presets. So they're going to have effects. It's going to have a certain sound to it. So it's going to have the effects. It's going to have the kits. It's going to have different grooves. So let's do, let's see. Let's check out this one first. You got some that sound like breaks, you got some that sound like, let's say, heavy metal, so you can pull this one up. Say we want to go over here to the groove, just so you can kind of see what's going on if we play it. You can see all the different grooves. You can lay out your stuff down here, so each different pattern you can kind of drag down there. It's kind of like a sequencer, so you can either have it looping or you can have it go through and play them in sequential order. So like I said, I really dig BFD3, man. Just BFD in general just sounds really great, but it's so flexible. You can see over here we got a few different, so we can change this. Let's say we want to turn down the ambient. Turn up the room. Turn down the overhead. So it's just so flexible in terms of what you can do. And remember, like I said, you can get a lot of different expansions for this. If you've had BFD2, then all that stuff works in here as well. So just crazy stuff. See, these two are linked, and the snare and the clap are linked. And what I like about it is just everything is made with real drums, so you get a real nice, you know, just acoustic organic sound. But of course, with all those different effects, you can do pretty much whatever you want with this. So say we want to go check out the grooves. So crazy. Like I said, remember, you can drag this stuff out. You can mess with the swing. You can mess with the humanization. Let's just start doing some of that really quick. So yeah, man, hopefully you kind of get the idea. I'm really a huge fan of BFD. It's definitely my favorite drum plugin. I tend to go to this a lot more than even drum samples, just because I like using a lot of acoustic, you know, drum kits, just real organic kits. And there's so many different styles and ways that you can tweak your drums in here that is just endless. A lot of times I don't really mess with the grooves myself unless I'm just kind of doing some standalone stuff and messing with the kits and building up my own grooves. But there's a lot of stuff in here if you really want that, you know, authentic drum groove sound, you can drag that into your DAW, drag it as audio or MIDI, and be good to go. But for me, I just like the flexibility of the different types of kits, different kit parts, you know, all the different stuff that you can pull up. And I really, if you've used previous versions, then you know how awesome this is. For me, you know, I love being able to quickly go into the different expansions if I want specific, like if I want to go quickly into the jazz and funk expansion, I can. The percussion, you know, the 8-bit kit, all the different stuff I can quickly pull and focus just on those. But overall, man, really, really dope. Like I said, if you're into, you know, acoustic drums, kits, and even with like the different expansions, you can get so many different styles and kit parts and stuff. It's really, really flexible. So for me, man, like I said, this is my favorite drum plug. And you can get this joint directly from FXpansion website or, you know, any place that sells their software. Now, I believe, let me pull it up right quick, because it's like $349 if you just want to download the full version. If you don't have a previous version, if you're upgrading from BFD2 and you want to download it, it's $149. If you want the physical, it's $199. If you're upgrading from BFD Echo, you can see right there, $314. So really, really cool stuff. Again, I definitely use this a lot. I definitely suggest if you're looking for just real authentic acoustic drums, a lot of different flexibility, you definitely check this out. So let me know what you think. Of course, if you got any questions about it, let me know. I'll be doing separate videos on some of the expansions that you can get for BFD. But again, this is something I've been using for a long time. Definitely wanted to make sure I let you know about this. So this is St. Joe, boomandbap.com. Let me know what you think below. Rate, comment, subscribe, share if you love what I'm doing. And I'll see y'all later. Peace.